Hi students, in this video class I am going to explain you about the different types of sorting. First of all, what is a sorting? Sorting means to arrange the list of different values either in ascending or in descending order. A list can be an array or a linked list. So here we will apply on the arrays. So different types of techniques are there. So we can say different types of sorting techniques are there. See here, one is bubble sort, selection sort, insertion sort, quick sort, merge sort, radix sort or bucket sort, heap sort, and many other sorting, shell sort, shuttle sort. There are various types of sortings. In this class, I am going to explain you only about the bubble sorting first of all. Bubble sorting, how to apply bubble sorting. Suppose we have some values which are not arranged. Values are 25, 60, 40, 20, and 15. So we have to shift the values from here to here and here to here. It means we need swapping. Swapping means exchange. So in according to bubble sort technique, what we have to do? We have to compare first value with the second value. If first value is greater than second value, then only we will exchange. But here first value is not greater than the second value, so do not exchange these two values. Now compare these two values. 60 is greater than 40, swap the values. Exchange. Now 60 is greater than 20, compare these two. Here is now 60. So compare these two. 60 is greater than 20, again exchange. Now compare these two. 60 is greater than 15, yes. Exchange or swap. So what we did here, we have compared A0, A0 means array A0 with A1, A1 with A2, A2 with A3, A3 with A4. So four comparison we have done here. So what we got at the end? At the end, the biggest value, 60, it was here, but now after the process, it is here. So, one value is arranged and it comes at its position at the end, the biggest one. So, this is called first round. Now, same process we have to repeat second time. Second time, again, now values are 25, 40, 20, 15 and 60. 25 is greater than 40? No, do not swap. 40 is greater than 20? Yes, swap. 40 is greater than 15? Yes, swap. 40 is greater than 60? No. And never be. Because already the biggest one is at the end. How 40 can be greater than 60? It can be equal or less. So whether you compare or not, 40 will remain here and 60 will be here. So second value will be arranged. 40 was here, now it is here. Two values are now arranged in second round. Third round, same process. Values are 25, 20 and 15 and then these are arranged. 25 is greater than 20? Yes, swap. 25 greater than 15? Yes, swap. 25 greater than 40? Cannot be. So 25 is not greater than 40 because it was already arranged. And 40 can never be greater than 60. So third value is now also arranged. Now fourth round. 20 is greater than 15? Yes. 15 and 20 will be exchanged. Now already it was arranged. So 20 will be arranged. And now 15 will be automatically arranged. So now these values are in ascending order. So four times we have repeat the process of comparison and swapping. Now we have to make the program for it. I am making one class sorting and taking some values A equal to same values I have taken 25, 60, 40, 25, 60, 40, 20 and 15. And making one function void bubble sort taking two variables I, j and one more variable t for swapping
I, j for the loops because we have to make a nested loop. Try to understand how I am making nested loops.
For j equal to 0, j is less than a dot length minus 1 j plus plus. If a j is greater than a j plus 1, then swap. Third variable is t equal to a j. A j equal to a j plus 1 and a j plus 1 equal to t.
First of all, try to understand this loop. J is 0. Here j plus 1 inside the a array. 0, a 0 will be compared with a 1, the next adjacent value. If first one is greater than the second, then only it will be swapped. T equal to a j, a j equal to a j plus 1, a j plus 1 equal to t. If first one is greater than second, next adjacent value, then only it will be swapped. If it is not greater, then no swapping. Next. Next time I will be 1, then a 1 will be compared with a 2. Next time a 2 with a 3. Next time a 3 with a 4. Loop is up to a dot length minus 1, length is 5 and 5 minus 1 is 4, it means j is less than 4 and less than 4 means up to 3. Last value of j will be 3. So, if a 3 is greater than a 4, last comparison. So, 4 times it will execute. So, this loop will arrange only one value. 60 will be arranged. Now, we have to repeat the same process. So, you need nested loop here. Make one more loop for I equal to 0, I is less than a dot length minus 1, I plus plus. Same number of iterations. We need 4 iterations. So, I 0 to less than 4, 0, 1, 2, 3. So, 4 times this loop will be repeated. This is outer loop, this is inner, this is the function. So, first time when I is 0, it will arrange 60, first value. Second time when I is 1, it will again repeat it. It will arrange 40. Third time, it will arrange 25. And fourth time, it will arrange 20. That will be automatically arranged. Now, one more thing important. In first round, 60 will be here. 60 will come here. One value will be arranged. In second round, when I will be 1, when I will be 1, this loop will be repeated and 4 times it will execute. It will compare this with this, this with this, this with this and 40 with 60 finally, which is not required in second round. You can compare. It will not be exchanged. Array will be arranged. But extra comparison is not allowed. So, do not compare 40 with 60 in second round. For this, what you can do? You can write minus I here. I is 0 in first round, 4 comparisons will be there. Next time, I is 1. When I is 1, so 4 minus 1, 3, j is less than 3. Loop will execute 3 times. So, only 3 comparisons will be there in second iteration. And in third iteration, again, I will become 2. So, a dot length minus 1 minus 2. So, it will be less than 2. So, only 2 comparisons will be there. In this way, you can apply. If you will not apply, array will be arranged. But it will increase the complexity of the program. Extra comparison, useless comparisons is not required. So, this is a complete function. But you have to make the complete program. You have to display the value and to check what will be the output. So, what you can do? You can make one more function display void
display, make the loop, and I equal to 0, a dot length, I is less than a dot length, and here you can print and check the values. You can write print ln, then simply it will come in vertical order. All the values can be printed inside this loop.
So now main function,
you can make public static void main function, in which create the object of class sorting, sorting object equal to new sorting object dot bubble sort. First of all, call the function bubble sort, it will arrange the value, then call the function display to print all the values, close the function and then close the class.
Now we have applied the sorting on only these fixed values. Rest of the thing means you can also make one input or accept function to store the values, to store the size of the array. That thing you can also do, as we have already done in the previous classes. So this is about the bubble sorting. That's all.